to Game On, and as we promised, we have Jerry Sikhosana here and me. I'm going to talk all things local football. Let's start off, Jerry. Firstly, I hope you're having a good day. It's a great weekend, good football to look forward to. But let's start off by talking about Mamelodi Sundowns. Doing well on the continent, Bashaya Young, not too long ago. Also, focusing on the league, Babuya Bashaya Cape Town Spurs in 1-0. They're just stretching that unbeaten run now, 44 matches. They are looking as though it was not the season, Mangasha.
Yeah, Sizwe, I think a credit to Mamelodi Sundowns, because globally, they've been regarded as one of the best teams in terms of winning streak, you know, being unbeaten. So if you look, also look at the Champions League against the Younger, well, controversial goal.
Yeah, bro. People goal line technology,
But yeah, let's congratulate Sundowns for advancing into the next stage. And also, you look at the league. I mean, I always say Sundowns, how many players do they have?
Yeah,
because you can play Sundowns three games in Elang Eli one. They will always get along good in terms of results and players. But look, I think Rhulani Mokwena is the one that needs to get the best credit ever as a coach. Because as a coach, Mao, if you work with a big number of players, you need to understand all of these
players. All of those players.
And how many are there at Sundowns? So give credit to him because he's handling the job at Sundowns so well.
Now, another team that's maybe is a bit of a surprise package for some, but not for people like you that watch and understand football. Stellenbosch FC, 20 matches unbeaten in all competitions. 20 for Stellenbosch. They are another side this season that is showing us, look, within the years to come, you'll be a problem. If I can't be a problem, my mind.
You know, something which we don't look at, Tina, as South Africans, it's the way Stellenbosch se produce our players. If you can ask somebody as much as Stellenbosch number two to say, can you mention maybe four players who Stellenbosch? You were difficult.
Yeah, bro.
Because the way they do things, you know, it's like players that are unknown. But when they come into the limelight, they're doing well. You know, you're talking about Van Wyk, Reyners, Titus, you know, all of those players. I mean, it's just a good team. I mean, what Steve Parker is doing, not to go for the so-called big name players. He's the one that normally produces players for other clubs because people wanna look at what he's doing. Because in the promotion from the development to Stellenbosch, and look at where they are now.
Let's just focus on one's big players, man. Especially 8071. One player that's made me very happy, Umabasa. Before the season started, he started to find his form, the confidence. Why was built on that confidence. Man, yeah, it's red hot, Lapak Pirates.
Yeah, let's not just charge Ngekeme one.
Sure.
Because we make him. He's the same player that missed the penalty.
Sure.
He scored a hat trick, but he also missed the penalty.
Yeah,
what if it was the most important penalty that he missed in that result? Yes, they won 7, a good score, but Yasmin among fire like us, man. Why bang a flung a cool? Maybe by win a 2-1, the other 5 transfer one yama game. But yeah, if it's your day on the day, good. But you look at when they lost to Iskukune, it wasn't a good thing, you know. But yeah, let's give credit to them. Let's hope they will continue doing that, especially Umabas.
You know, now for the last 3-4 weeks, Kuna, Chippa United, East London, the crowd they get there. So my Chiefs are here for Asha Ilape.
But as even below season, I told you me East London.
Yeah, it's
been East London.
Yeah.
East London.
Well, it's East London.
That was something which everybody would be glued to, you know, because Chiefs are not doing well. Chippa, not a big team, anybody can follow. But that game was like, for me, one of the best.
How do you see the performance? Performance is Chippa. 2-0.
Both teams.
Yeah.
Yes, both teams. Chiefs were just unlucky not to score.
Yeah.
But it was a good game to follow.
Good crowd.
Good crowd.
Yeah.
You know, even the weather wasn't that good. Pitch was slippery. But this is what you want to see in South African football. Because as a player myself, if I have to give the performance, it's because of the people on the outside that gives you the oomph, you know, the courage and everything in you to give so that everybody's happy. You know, you look at the you understand the people that were glued on the TV screen, the people that went into the stadium. To me, it was a good advert for our DSTV Premiership.
Let's talk about Chiefs, the Kevin Johnson. Maybe some of the fans might be getting a bit frustrated. 14 games now. Oh, Johnson has been in charge. He's won five. That's 15 points. He's drawn four. That's 4 points. He's lost five. 19 points from 42. It's not even 50%.
No, not at all, not at all. I think the pressure that the... I think if Mfaka and the Mutau family are getting through, it's like chopping and changing of coaches. It's not good for a big club like that. You need consistency. We coach or hire really. So the way Ngakona manager, things are not rosy for the Chiefs, especially the technical team.
Yeah.
But I cannot fault Kevin Johnson, you know, because we don't know what's inside happening there at the Chiefs camp. But if you see them on the outside, he's not somebody who's talkative or shouting on the bench. He's always like that. His coaching philosophy is being quiet, give whatever that you give, good dressing room, give players whatever that you want. But let's hope things will be better. 7 games to go, 21 points. Let's see how many they're going to accumulate.
Now, let's focus on Nedbank Cup quickly, the games that are coming up. Namhlanje, Stellenbosch, SuperSport United. Entertaining game there. Stellenbosch, of course, they continue to entertain.
Yeah, Sibonile Kutibenzani in terms of Elikin. It's a good encounter. But I'll give it to Stellis.
Stellis.
This one, Stellis will go through to the semis.
And then Durban against Josie, AmaZulu. Pirates, 6 o'clock, Ndama.
Yeah, you know, if Pirates carry the same mentality,
yeah,
Lebi Banayo against another KZN team in Arrows. Bazuba Rat. I can give it to Pirates.
Sure. Away from home still?
Yep, away
okay.
from home.
Former champions, Galaxy, up against Chippa United. Chippa United, but the confidence, Lebi to look shy Chiefs, but. So even Anjan.
But where are they going? By Mbombela. And you know, TS Galaxy, hey, they don't take anything for granted when they are there.
Yeah.
They want to make sure that they continue. So, for Bona, they want to see themselves again in the final. You know what happened when they played against the Kaizer Chiefs? They were still in the second division. So, let's hope they will do well. But, yeah, I'll give it to TS Galaxy.
Well, there you have it. Those are the predictions, of course, from Jerry Sikhosana. Looking back as well at the games that took place in as far as the DSTV Premiership. So, let's look forward to the Nedbank Cup games and discuss them with Jerry Sikhosana come next week.